Connor Stevenson, the champion of hope. Amazing recovery story. Was in a coma after a fight for about 11 months, I think, 9 months.
And Rex Walker, present them with the robe. Rex Walker was a supervisor of the fight between Adonis and Gvozdik. And we live difficult moments. He was 18 days with him in a coma, and through the love, through the prayers of the whole world, one day he opened his eyes and he's here doing great.
Round of applause for Superman!
That was a miracle man.
Okay, we got another champion who's in attendance. Champion of life. Here's his video. Long time friend of mine, just met him yesterday. Billy Dim.
He's a huge champion of the world. Why do we admire boxers so much? Why is it such an adrenaline rush to see them in the ring doing what they do best? And then finally, for the few, the culmination of all those years of blood, sweat, and tears, when they joyfully hold aloft the green and gold belt, that unique and supreme moment. That's the power and the glory of boxing, which makes it undoubtedly the greatest sport of them all. With its crown jewel greats, Joe Louis, Ali, Tyson, Salvador Sanchez, Hamill, Foreman, Chavez, and the rest of the best, who defied the odds, persevered, simply refusing to be second by triumphing with sheer willpower. That's what boxing's all about. The heart and the soul driven by the mindset. Never better highlighted than when Julio Cesar Chavez dug so deep to defeat Nardrick Taylor in those few remaining seconds of that fabled final round, seizing victory from the jaws of defeat. He willed himself to win against all the odds. Absolutely incredible. The coronation of a superstar. Determination, resolve, and true grit when Tyson Fury competed again for the title after fighting inner battles and banishing cruel demons which had afflicted him for more than 3 years. How he somehow got up from the canvas after being knocked down so hard, motivated by intangible forces urging him to continue fighting. It seemed all over. But a true champion gets up when he or she can't. So perhaps boxing reminds us of life itself. It's not how you get knocked down, rather it's how you get up and fight back. What we do in moments of adversity makes us who we are, and it defines us. Billy Dib is the finest example of sheer undaunted courage. The son of immigrants from Lebanon who made Australia their home, Billy was born with chronic asthma. He spent the first 6 months of his life in an incubator. At the age of 11, his dad took him to the gym to teach him how to defend himself against bullies, and then Billy fell in love with boxing. A great amateur career, but then another setback as a motorcycle accident prevented him from being selected for the Olympics. As a pro, Billy won the world title and competed for the green and gold belt far above his natural weight. Then, the hardest blow of all, Billy was diagnosed with stomach cancer. He was going to have to undergo chemotherapy, and Billy hesitated. It's natural to fear and trepidation because we're all human, but the bravest of the brave overcome it, press on and fight back. Billy was determined to somehow come through this ordeal for his family. So for 6 agonizing months, Billy underwent treatment that took him to the very outer limits. He lost his hair, endured blinding headaches, nausea, sleeplessness, and constant searing pain. Fighting and resisting with absolutely everything he learned as a boxer, and then even more. He was down, but not out. He got back up, and that's what it's all about. Billy's written a biography entitled True Heart. He inspires and encourages those facing the terrors of cancer. In his pro career, Billy did fought 56 fights. Then there was number 57. a fight he had to win because it was for the fight of his life. But as such a lucky man, he has the love and support of wife Berry, Curdy, Dib, and his entire family. No blessing is greater. I can't think of anyone who deserves this Champion of Hope award more than Billy Dib. Why Champion of Hope? Because hope springs eternal. Billy Dib, a champion of the ring, a champion of life, a champion of hope, and our champion forever.
The first champion of hope, that is Steve's, to the new one, Billy Dib. And presenting him with the robe of hope, we have the good board of governors, Frank Hadley, Pat Cusick, and of course, Mauricio Suleiman. Champions of Hope. Billy Dib, can we have some words of hope, please, from you? I wrote his speech. He's going to give you guys a speech, you know.
Be for me, you guys. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hola, ¿cómo estás? I'd like to thank the WC boxing community for reaching out during the most challenging time of my life. On October 12, 2022, I was diagnosed with a life-ending cancer. The doctors told me that I had 6 months to live. I was set to face an opponent that I couldn't see. However, with faith, family, friendship and love, I was able to overcome this horrible disease. One of the phone calls that I'll never forget, and I hold close to my heart, was from a dear friend of mine, Mauricio Suleiman. He told me that I had a champion's heart, and I could win this battle with cancer. In fact, he was so confident that he said he would see me at the next convention, and I'm here now. He also promised that he was going to present me with a WBC World Championship. Again, he kept his word. I'd like to thank the boxing family for the outpouring of support. Because without your support, I don't know if I'd be here today. The one thing I learned during my time in hospital is that time is something that's not promised. So my advice to everyone here is, only spend your time with people that you value, because time is something that you'll never get back. Thank you so much, guys.